各位来宾、各位线上和现场的朋友，大家下午好，欢迎各位出席由香港特别行政区政府、投资推广署、深圳市商务局和深圳市前海管理局合办，中央人民政府驻香港特别行政区联络办公室、经济部贸易处支持的香港深圳投资交流会金融及现代服务业专题。 Honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon and a warm welcome to all of you to today's Hong Kong Shenzhen Investment Forum Financial and Professional Services. This hybrid event is presented by Invest Hong Kong, the government of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, in collaboration with the Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality and the authority of Qianhai Shenzhen-Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen, supported by the Commercial Office of the Economic Affairs Department of the Liaison Office of the Central People's Government in Hong Kong, SAR. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Patricia, and I'm your MC today. 我是今天的主持人杨凯珍 Patricia, 大家下午好. Thank you. This is our very first hybrid forum connecting two physical events in both Shenzhen and Hong Kong, with our overseas participants joining via Zoom as well. We're excited to have over 130 participants in the venue here in Hong Kong and in Shenzhen. Thank you very much for your support and attendance. 那这个呢，是我们首个联合连接深圳和香港的两个实体活动现场的混合交流会。还有呢，正在通过 Zoom 参与的海外观众朋友，今天呢，在现场 香港和深圳加起来，我们有超过130位的朋友出席本次的活动。我们再一次邀请大家用掌声欢迎在座的每一位，可以吗？Welcome. 那首先让我来介绍一下今天在香港和深圳会场的嘉宾们。Let me first introduce our honorable guests here in Hong Kong and Shenzhen today. In Hong Kong, we have 在香港的会场，我们有 Mr. Stephen Phillips, Director General of Investment Promotion of Invest Hong Kong. 香港投资推广署署长傅仲森先生 Mr. Guo Jinyou, Second Level Inspector of the Commercial Office of Economic Affairs Department of the Liaison Office of the Central People's Government in Hong Kong, SAR 掌声欢迎中央人民政府驻香港特别行政区联络办公室经济部贸易处二级巡视员郭金友先生继续欢迎前海管理局香港事务首席联络官 洪卫民教授JP, Professor Whitman Hong JP, Principal Liaison Officer for Hong Kong of the Shenzhen Qianhai Authority. Next, we also have Dr. Jimmy Chang, Associate Director General of Investment Promotion Business Development of Invest Hong Kong, 香港投资推广署助理署长业务发展蒋学礼博士，欢迎. Next, we also have Ms. Jennifer Tan, Chief Executive, Alipay Financial Services Hong Kong Limited, 来自 Alipay Financial Services Hong Kong Limited 的行政总裁陈婉珍女士，掌声欢迎。 Next, we also have Ms. Jasmine Lee, Partner, Chinese Inbound Business Leader Financial Services Ernst & Young Global Limited, 安永香港中资金融业务主管合伙人李顺儿女士，掌声欢迎。 Also, we have Mr. KK Chu, Chief Executive of Greater China, Cushman & Wakefield, 大德良行大中华区环球董事行政总裁赵锦泉先生，掌声欢迎。那在深圳的会场呢，我们有 in Shenzhen we have 深圳市商务局局长张飞梦女士 Miss 张飞梦 Director General of Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality 深圳市前海深港现代服务业工作合作区管理局常务副局长黄小鹏先生 Mr. 黄小鹏 First Deputy Director General of Authority of Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen. 我们还有深圳市的商务局副局长简正先生, Mr. Jian Zheng, Deputy Director General of Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality. 我们深圳的嘉宾呢，还有好几位，我们逐一介绍一下。我们有深圳市前海深港现代服务业合作区管理局副局长袁富勇先生, Mr. Yuan Fuyong, Deputy Director General of Authority of Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen. 来自深圳的还有深圳市创新投资集团有限公司副总裁张建先生, Mr. Paulette Zhang, Vice President, Shenzhen Capital Group Company Limited. 我们继续欢迎的有波士顿咨询公司 BCG 全球合伙人兼董事总经理郭毅先生, Mr. Guo Yi, Partner and Managing Director, Boston Consulting Group. 在深圳方面的嘉宾，我们还有深圳市地方金融监督管理局金融服务处处长林志凯先生 ，Mr. 林志凯 ，Director of Financial Services Division, Local Financial Regulatory Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality, and Mr. Ryan Wang, General Manager of Shenzhen Region Texas Instruments， 还有是来自德州仪器半导体技术有限公司的深圳地区销售总经理王凡先生。我们再一次热烈的掌声欢迎所有出席的领导嘉宾们。Once again, a very warm welcome to all the guests and distinguished guests attending today. Well, as we all know, Hong Kong and Shenzhen are two core powerhouses in the Guangdong-Hong Kong-Macau Greater Bay Area, particularly in the financial and professional services sectors. The two cities complement each other to achieve mutual benefits and create synergies. Hong Kong and Shenzhen will be working as a dual engine in the regional development. And in just a minute, you'll see a video which we proudly present today that showcases the energy of these two highly dynamic cities. 那我们都知道呢，香港和深圳是粤港澳大湾区内两个在金融和现代服务业的重镇啊，两地呢各有优势，合作的空间庞大之余呢，可以互补不足，也是达至互利共赢。香港和深圳将会共同的打造双城经济，发挥双引擎的功能。我们今天呢也特别准备了一条的视频，让大家呢通过科技感受一下两个姐妹城市的活力。 确实呢是精彩万分。那两个先进的城市活力满载，的确呢能够为年轻人以至我们全球的投资者带来很多的新机会。香港与深圳一直呢关系非常的密切，也是呢我们在香港特别行政区政府投资推广署和深圳市商务局在去年就联合举办了一系列的活动，希望呢可以透过不同的渠道向全球的投资者介绍香港和深圳的机遇。 So as you can see from the video just now, Hong Kong and Shenzhen are truly dynamic and full of exciting opportunities. I'm sure many of our participants and also our viewers online would like to know more about the opportunities and possibilities in these two cities, and we say twin cities as well. So actually, Hong Kong and Shenzhen are working very closely together as close partners. And Invest Hong Kong, together with Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality, co-organized a series of events last year to promote the business advantages of Hong Kong and Shenzhen to our global investors. 那接下来我们再一次看一下我们的屏幕，一同重温过往活动的精彩场面，还有深港合作的成果。Now let's take a look at the highlights of the exciting events from last year. Please enjoy.
Japan has always been an important trading partner for Hong Kong.
So we hope that all the partners in the region will find a very suitable ecosystem here in Shenzhen.
Hong Kong and Shenzhen represented two of the main engines of the economy within GDA.
Shenzhen is the frontier of the China reform agenda.
Invest Hong Kong can help your business expand in GBA, BBA.
Shenzhen has a long history of collaboration.
Is one of the economic engines of the original Hong Kong cloud winter Bay Area.
Shenzhen will act as the core engine of the Guangdong, Hong Kong, Macau, Greater Bay Area.
Should we give a big round of applause again to Invest Hong Kong and Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality for the great effort in bringing Hong Kong and Shenzhen to the world and to showcase to our global investors the opportunities and the benefits for investing in these two cities. 那接下来我们有请香港投资推广署署长傅仲森先生为我们致欢迎词。 Now, with much honor, we would like to invite Mr. Stephen Phillips, Director General of Investment Promotion of Invest Hong Kong, to come on stage for an opening remarks. Please welcome Mr. Phillips.
Right. Big question. Do I stand on the box or not stand on the box? Madam Zhang, Mr. Huang, Mr. Guo, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, may I add my very warm welcome to this afternoon's forum. It's quite nice actually to see the shots back in Lisbon in November last year, and again to be doing a collaborative event with our great partners in Shenzhen. And I really would like to thank all of you, whether our partners in Shenzhen, our speakers, and all of you in the audience, both here in Hong Kong, in Shenzhen and online, for joining us today. Today we're going to be exploring how Shenzhen and Hong Kong can really deepen our cooperation and collaboration, specifically in financial and professional services. It really goes without saying that Hong Kong and Shenzhen have their own unique and very strong advantages and favorable features in the business environments. Hong Kong, of course, is one of the world's leading international financial centers, hosting the largest offshore renminbi hub, as well as being an international asset management center, risk management center, and much, much more. Since I first visited Shenzhen back in 1990, as it happens, as a banker, and a much slimmer banker, Shenzhen has really transformed into such a modern, vibrant city with a wealth of talent from all over the country and from all over the world. And of course, we've seen the really strong economic growth that has fueled the growth of Shenzhen. Now home to a lot of financial technology, fintech companies, and of course, a hotbed of innovation in the country. As the dual engines of the Greater Bay Area, both places really can leverage much more our complementary strengths and advantages by working together through deeper collaboration. And that will be key to taking forward development within the region. Hong Kong's relationship with Shenzhen Municipality is already very strong. We have extensive collaboration in so many different areas, from cross-border infrastructure, financial and professional services, and particularly from the point of view of Invest Hong Kong, around investment promotion. Indeed, last year we set up an even more comprehensive collaboration mechanism for investment promotion with Shenzhen, and you've just seen a few of the highlights in the video now. Under the mechanism, Invest Hong Kong and our partners, the Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality, have been working really closely together on a lot of different fronts. But it really is about leveraging that dual strength to attract inward investment from around the world, and in particular, inward investment into GBA. We think there's been a lot of good achievements, but there's much, much more that we can do in the months and years ahead. And I know that on behalf of my team, we're really looking forward to taking all of this work forward. Perhaps I could just very briefly recap some of Hong Kong's strengths in financial and professional services. As we all know, Hong Kong is one of the top three international financial centres, with a powerful combination of attributes, including our prime geographic location right at the very heart of Asia, rule of law, open and efficient markets, free flow of information, capital and people, as well as a low and simple tax system. Also, we have a robust financial regulatory regime, world-class indeed, and the absence of capital control also creates opportunities for a range of financial services businesses. And of course, Hong Kong is easy to set up a business. The Closer Economic Partnership, CEPA, also gives unique opportunities for Hong Kong companies to tap into opportunities across the mainland, including in financial and professional services. Of course, all of this is underpinned by our very deep financial, legal, accounting, and many other professional services in Hong Kong, including arbitration and intellectual property protection. And this is why Hong Kong acts as such a regional, international hub for more than 9,000 businesses from all around the world. And that's an increase of 10% over the last 4 years. So don't believe everything that you read in the media. Hong Kong also offers a really great testing environment for entrepreneurs to turn innovative ideas into products or services that can launch to international markets. We have a vigorous startup ecosystem with over 3,700 startups, again last year, at a record number of startups and employing a record number of people, up an amazing 70% over the last 4 years. Again, not what the media would necessarily have you believe. What about seizing the opportunities within GBA? Obviously, the unique positioning of Hong Kong under one country, two systems is key to Hong Kong's participation as a key city within GBA. The significant transportation and infrastructure projects that have been put in place over the last few years are really improving the connectivity, whether it's the bridge connecting Hong Kong to Zhuhai and Macau, or the rail links that mean you can get to Shenzhen and Guangzhou-Nan within 48 minutes these days. Lots of things that really will turn GBA into a reality. International companies can seize the commercial opportunities in GBA by utilizing the strengths of Hong Kong. And perhaps I could just illustrate this by a few examples within financial and professional services. As a world-leading banking and financial center, serving as the two-way gateway between the international business community and the mainland, Hong Kong has become a global hub for offshore remnant B business, as I've mentioned already. We've seen the Stock Connect and Bond Connect schemes link the capital markets between both the mainland and Hong Kong, and that goes from strength to strength. And more recently, we've seen the cross-boundary Wealth Management Connect scheme up and running within the GBA. And that's already getting a lot of traction in terms of the number of businesses participating, and indeed in terms of the number of individuals using the Wealth Connect scheme to make their investments. Currently, 24 banks have begun to offer products under the Wealth Management Connect scheme, and over 24,000 individuals are already participating in it. On the professional services side, Hong Kong really does offer the full range of professional services that any business needs, as befits an international center. Whether it's legal, arbitration, accountancy, project management, risk management, consulting, engineering, PR, marketing, you'll find all the expertise that you need to help your business thrive, whether in Hong Kong, in the mainland, or in global markets. Specifically, there are supporting measures within the context of GBA that will increasingly allow professionals to practice not only in Hong Kong, but also within GBA, specifically for construction professionals. And recently, in the legal sphere, Hong Kong lawyers can take a particular qualification, the GB Legal Professional Examination, to enable them to practice not only in Hong Kong, but also in the mainland. So I think we'll see more and more business-friendly policies over the months and years to come, and that's going to benefit investors from around the world to tap into the opportunities within GBA. There's a lot more scope for deeper integration between the financial markets of the mainland and Hong Kong and the rest of the world, and that will also be at the very heart of the development of the Greater Bay Area. At Invest Hong Kong, we're going to work even more closely with the Bureau of Commerce in Shenzhen Municipality to promote these opportunities to the international business community. This afternoon, we've got a fantastic lineup of expert speakers who will be sharing with you much more granular insights into the opportunities that they see, that they're facilitating. So I really do hope that we all learn something new this afternoon and that we go away enthused about the potential for the links between Hong Kong and Shenzhen and how GBA can be turned into the economic powerhouse that I'm sure we all know is within the realms of possibility. So thank you once again for joining us and good afternoon.
Thank you very much, Mr. Phillips. Please be seated, thank you. 谢谢副署长的发言. Next, Ms. Zhang Fei-Meng, Director General of the Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality, will deliver her opening remarks in Shenzhen. 以下我们有请深圳市商务局局长张飞梦女士在深圳会场为我们致开幕词，有请张局长。
尊敬的香港投资推广署署长、副总深先生，尊敬的中央人民政府驻香港特别行政区联络办公室经济部贸易处二级巡视员郭进友先生，尊敬的前海深港现代服务业合作区管理局常务副局长黄晓鹏先生，各位企业家朋友们，女士们、先生们，大家下午好，非常荣幸。 能够在距离香港回归祖国25周年还仅有7天的时候，深圳市商务局和前海管理局与我们香港投资推广署的同行们，能够在今天下午这样一个美好的时间，通过我们两地线下峰会场，在线上相约的方式，来举办我们香港深圳投资交流会的金融及现代 服务业的专场活动，我谨代表深圳市商务局向出席我们今天活动的各位新老企业家朋友们表达我们最热烈的欢迎以及我们最衷心的感谢。今年呢是一个非常让我们觉得会有很多大事喜事发生的年份啊，既是我们即将迎来的 香港回归祖国25周年，也是我们粤港澳大湾区发展规划纲要印发实施的第四个年头。当然，更重要的是，在下半年，我们将迎来党的二十大胜利召开。那么，在这样一个喜庆的年份啊，作为香港和深圳两地的唇齿相依，刚才呢，副终身署长也专门提到啊，我们不仅两地在地缘上啊。 从我们出生开始就在一起，更重要的是，在过去深圳改革开放40年的发展进程中，香港和深圳同步发展，更给予了深圳非常多的生机和活力啊。那么我们两地呢，也一直按照习近平总书记对广东深圳系列重要讲话精神，我们保持着非常紧密的合作，共同来推动我们深港两地的高质量发展。 过去的一段时间，尤其是我们看到的去年啊，香港和深圳，我们在全球同步、同时、同场 举办了多场这样的一个活动，双方呢高层也达成了多项的共识。那么我们深圳市商务局和香港投资推广署呢，按照我们双方高层达成共识的要求，共同承担了在全球推广两地招商的这样的一些工作，也取得了一些成绩。尤其是从2021年以来，我们深圳市商务局和香港投资推广署，我们研究制定并且呢共同推进了一系列的重要的方案。我们先后在美国、日本、欧洲、澳大利亚等地呢举办了超过十场的经贸交流活动。我们也向全球发布了携手湾区共赢未来的宣传片。刚才大家看到呢是一个45秒的精彩的剪辑，其实我们在全球的各个场地呢还有一个更加的完整版。我们也非常欢迎呢我们的企业家朋友们，同时此时在线上参加我们的朋友们，也可以上到深圳商务局和香港投资推广署的网站去观看我们的完整版，相信会给你带来更能够给你更好的一个体验。那么同时呢，今天我们还会共同签署深圳市商务局和香港投资推广署合作备忘录。我们相信这一切呢，对于我们深化深港更紧密的合作，提升深港市场一体化水平，携手打造国际一流湾区和世界级的城市群，具有非常重要的意义。所以在这一点上，我非常认同刚才傅中生署长讲到的，这也是我们两个部门为香港回归祖国25周年的一个重要的献礼。那么作为深圳呢，相信大家呢也都非常的了解了。那么当下呢，深圳进入了粤港澳大湾区深圳先行示范区的双区驱动和深圳经济特区、深圳先行示范区双区叠加的黄金发展时期，更是迎来了我们深圳改革综合试点全面深化前海深港现代服务业合作区的这样的一个重要的改革机遇啊。前海呢，作为我们香港同行应该是非常的不陌生啊。前海市总书记亲自谋划、亲自部署、亲自推动的国家改革开放的重大举措，一会儿呢我们前海管理局的袁富勇局长还会跟大家做详细的介绍。最后我衷心的希望我们深港两地的企业家朋友们可以通过我们今天金融及现代服务业的专场的活动，更好地了解深港两地在这个领域上我们双方的政府非常坚定的支持，以及我们双方非常优厚的这样的一个合作的机遇。我也很期待我们的全球企业家朋友们能够深知我们粤港澳大湾区这片沃土，能够在深港两地的联手推进上获得更丰厚的投资回报啊！投资粤港澳大湾区，共赢未来。感谢您的聆听，谢谢。
谢谢张局长为交流会揭开序幕，谢谢，请就坐。Thank you, Ms. Zhang. Next, Mr. Huang Xiaopeng, First Deputy Director General of the Authority of Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen, will deliver his opening remarks in Shenzhen. 接下来我们有请深圳市前海深港现代服务业工作区管理局常务副局长黄晓鹏先生在深圳会场为我们致开幕词，有请黄先生。
尊敬的傅仲生署长、飞梦局长、敬友巡视员、各位领导、各位嘉宾、女士们、先生们、先生们，大家下午好！非常高兴能和深港两地金融以及现代服务业的优秀企业家朋友们共叙合作情谊，共谋协作发展。在这里我仅代表前海管理局对莅临前海会场以及在香港视频连线的各界嘉宾表示热烈的欢迎，对香港投资推广署、深圳商务局在我们深圳前海以及在香港共同举办投资交流会表示衷心的感谢。前海位于内外循环交汇的重要节点，叠加了多重的国家重大战略的利好，既有依托香港服务内地面向世界的独特优势，是链接大湾区与全国以及全球商机的最佳平台。中共中央、国务院印发的前海方案描绘了前海打造全面深化改革创新试验平台、建设高水平对外开放门户枢纽的美好蓝图。前海已经成为大湾区 改革创新的高地，投资兴业的沃土。一是外资港资最积极，截止到今年五月份，前海注册外资企业达到1.31万家，其中港资企业达到9600多家，注册资本1000万以上的港企达到4100多家。三湾片区，也就是我们大家比较熟悉的前湾、桂湾、妈湾三个片区，在过去的一年里，在地的港企同比增长了124%，世界500强的企业投资在前海有326家。DRGO、西门子、德州仪器、IBM、安盛等新落户前海，前海实际利用外资占到中国的3%，超过深圳的一半。那么这其中港资占比是超过90%，成为外资港资的首选地。二是发展要素最齐备，前海城市新中心集聚了山海林城岛港湾河等得天独厚的资源禀赋，扩区后的前海囊括了包括国际金融城、国际法务区、国际人才港、国际航运中心、还有会展中心等独一无二的开放要素。比如说我们在今年1月4号启用的国际人才港，一站式提供451项的人才服务，在今年一年里面就举办100项为人才提供的活动。那么深圳机场的货运航点达到57个，西部港区的航运线达到193个。在疫情的防控的背景之下，我们国际会展中心今年将举办70场的会展，满足外资港资的全需求。三是跨境金融最便利，前海持续深化以6个跨境为代表的跨境金融创新，承接 QFLP、WFI、PFM 等管理权限，全国首批的本外币合一银行账户试点，首批的跨国公司本外币一体化资金池业务试点率先在前海落地。 FD 账户的跨境收支规模以及这个相关的这些规模都达到了上海的这个体量，方便外资港资进得来。四是法治保障最完善。那么最近呢，最高人民法院出台了支持和保障前海改革开放的意见，前海适用意外法律、跨境司法协助安排等实现了新的突破。前海法院受理涉外涉港澳的案件在全国的基层法院里面排第一，适用香港法的审理的案件也在全国的基层法院排第一。前海深港国际法务区聚集了包括司法、仲裁、知识产权保护等前链条的法治机构有79家，保障外资港资发展好。五是政策支持最优惠，前海15%的这个企业所得税的优惠的目录，从过往的4个大类、25个小类，拓展到5个大类、30个小类。前海最近出台的产业集聚、金融、专业服务等这些产业政策，对港企是按照比内企上浮20%来去执行。同时，我们在前海也布局了外商投资权益保护工作站，香港贸发局内地首家的GoGBA 的港商服务站等。那么前海港澳一站通实现了逐步出港澳，一站式办理政务事务达到233项，服务外资港资不打烊。投资前海就是投资未来，我们将一如既往的为企业提供最优的服务，为投资创造最大的便利，为发展营造最佳的环境。诚挚邀请我们各位企业家选择前海、投资前海、扎根前海，在前海这片舞台上共享红利、共赢未来。最后也衷心祝愿各位领导、各位嘉宾身体健康、工作幸福、工作顺利、家庭幸福。谢谢大家。
谢谢黄先生，谢谢，请就坐。Thank you very much, Mr. Huang。以下我们进入主题演讲的部分，首先有请香港投资推广署助理署长、业务发展蒋学礼博士就香港的营商环境和投资优势发表演讲。Now we'll proceed to keynote speeches. We would like to first invite Dr. Jimmy Chang, Associate Director General of Investment Promotion, Business Development of Invest Hong Kong, to come on stage and tell us more about the business environment and the benefits of investing in Hong Kong. Please welcome Dr. Chang.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's really my great pleasure to represent Invest Hong Kong to share with you an update about Hong Kong's business environment, as well as our unique advantages and opportunities in the Greater Bay Area, echoing some of the key messages delivered by Stephen earlier. First of all, I would really like to re-emphasize the unique advantages of Hong Kong enjoyed under one country, two systems have remained unchanged. Being one of the most international cities of China, Hong Kong's institutions for foreign companies are really business friendly. It is one of the world's freest economy, the third global financial center, and the fifth most competitive economy, all underpinned by the rule of law. And our simple and competitive tax regime is very much appreciated by global investors. A robust business environment is evidenced by the presence of a very vibrant global business community here. According to our annual survey conducted last year, Hong Kong was home to 9,049 overseas and mainland companies, up 10% against 2017. Indeed, a record high number. And among them, 1,457 were utilizing Hong Kong as their regional headquarters. And our startup environment is developing very quickly. According to another survey, 3,755 startup companies were operating in Hong Kong last year, up 68% versus 2017. Also an all-time high. Interestingly, almost 30% of our startup founders here were actually coming from outside Hong Kong, particularly mainland China, US, UK, France, and India. This shows that there's really an international appeal in our startup environment here. And because of our unique and competitive business advantages, Hong Kong has been serving as a very effective two-way platform for international companies to access the GBA, the whole of China, ASEAN, Belt and Road, as well as for mainland Chinese companies to go global. In fact, in 2020, among the total FDI going into mainland China, 73% was from Hong Kong. And Hong Kong has applied to join the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, and our RCEP membership will certainly help us strengthen our role as a trade and investment conduit between mainland and the rest of the world. Hong Kong is facing tremendous opportunities, especially given the strong national policy support. According to China's dual circulation economic policy, the country will focus on developing its domestic market while not completely closing off itself to the rest of the world. Instead, it will open up even more and continue to pursue mutually beneficial trade and investment cooperation with other economies. And this economic strategy will create a lot of business opportunities for Hong Kong, which is well positioned to capture them by leveraging our role as a super connector. China's 14th five-year plan also mentions and reiterates its support the country's support for Hong Kong on four traditional areas, namely finance, transport, trade, and legal services and dispute resolution services. And it also, for the first time, mentions the country's support for Hong Kong in four new and emerging areas, namely aviation, innovation and technology, intellectual property trading, as well as cultural exchange between East and West. And we believe that these strategic sectors in Hong Kong will see exceptional growth opportunities in the near future, including certainly financial and professional services, the focus of today's forum. Hong Kong and Shenzhen are two of the core cities in the GBA, developing high-quality financial and professional services in both places is essential if the GBA is to flourish, and Hong Kong has much to offer and to benefit. On the one hand, financial integration between Hong Kong and the GBA is being greatly enhanced in recent years, thanks to the Stock Connect, Bond Connect, and Wealth Management Connect, creating a lot of business opportunities for the industry. On the other hand, given that innovation and technology is the key driving force for the GBA development, and Hong Kong is a great source of capital for startups and scale-ups operating in the region. And thirdly, given the important common objective to achieve carbon neutrality, Hong Kong is also very well positioned to raise funds for green projects happening in the GBA and beyond. And there have also been a lot of exciting regulatory developments in the GBA for the professional services sector, especially in the legal, accounting, and construction sectors. In short, many of these liberalization measures are making it much easier for Hong Kong-based firms to establish presence and operate in the GBA through, for example, much simplified procedure and more favorable treatment, and also for Hong Kong-based practitioners to practice in the GBA through, for example, mutual recognition of qualifications and other relevant professional examinations. Like the financial services industry, the professional services industry will also benefit from the net zero agenda, with growing opportunities for companies providing services like ESG data analysis and reporting. How can Invest Hong Kong help you? If you're interested in learning more about how to access the GBA through Hong Kong, Invest Hong Kong, especially our dedicated GBA team, will be more than happy to assist you. We have established a dedicated GBA website and also just published a very informative guidebook called A Practical Guide for Setting Up in the GBA via Hong Kong, which is available on our website. It contains detailed information about the latest developments in the GBA in some key strategic sectors, advice on winning strategies to succeed in the GBA with a lot of interesting case studies. It also introduces the latest developments of the Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone, about which our next speaker, Mr. Yuan, will certainly share with you more details. And if you are interested in setting up your presence in Hong Kong, we can provide you with a wide range of support services, tailor-made from the planning stage and actual setup all the way through to your continuous expansion in and via our city. So to conclude, Hong Kong's unique advantages remain robust, and our economic prospect is indeed very promising given the relatively fast growth of our mother country and the whole of Asia. And we look forward to getting connected with you and providing our services. Finally, I wish you all a very inspiring and fruitful forum. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chang, for painting an informative picture of the strengths of Hong Kong. Thank you. Please be seated. I'm sure we're all excited to learn the same about Qianhai. So in the next session, we're honored to have Mr. Yuan Fuyong, Deputy Director General of Authority of Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen, to share with us how is Qianhai complementing Hong Kong. 那我们了解过香港的情况之后，是时候了解一下前海如何构筑深港合作的桥头堡。以下的时间，我们很高兴邀请到深圳市前海深港现代服务业工作合作区管理局副局长袁富勇先生，为我们剖析前海怎样形成依托香港、服务内地、面向世界的优势。有请袁先生。
尊敬的副总审署长、尊敬的郭晋友巡视员、张飞梦局长、黄晓鹏常务副局长、各位领导、各位来宾、女士们、先生们，大家下午好。很高兴在前海向深港两地的朋友们介绍前海的最新开发建设情况，并共同探讨在前海的投资发展的新机遇。 推进前海开发开放是习近平总书记亲自谋划、亲自部署、亲自推动的新时代国家改革开放重大举措。党的十大八大以来，习近平总书记三次亲临前海，为前海的开发开放把脉定向。前海始终牢记习近平总书记的殷殷嘱托：依托香港，服务内地，面向世界。 精雕细琢，一张白纸，从零开始，打造最美最好的图画，打造最浓缩最精华的核心引擎。经过11年的发展，前海如今发展成什么样呢？请大家看一下这两张照片，这分别是2010年和2021年的前海的航拍图。通过这两张图的变化，大家可以直观地感受到。 前海这10年来的参山巨变，截止2021年末，原前海合作区累计注册的企业达到了12.09万家，实现税收收入566.61亿元，实际使用外资53.92亿元美元，累计约占全市的一半，进出口总额达按关区统计达到了1.47万亿元。 增长了19.2%，世界500强企业已有329家在前海投资。根据第三方机构评估，前海的模拟阴山环境排名在全球排在了第15位。在深港合作方面，前海全面贯彻"一国两制"方针，实施立港会港的万千百实工程。前海累计注册的企业。 感知企业达到了1.19万家，目前是现存的9000多家，累计使用感知达到了250.09亿美元。前海已经成为内地与香港关联度最高、合作最紧密的区域之一。2021年9月6日，中共中央、国务院对外发布了全面深化前海深港现代服务业合作区改革开放方案。 对前海提出了两大战略定位、三大任务要求、两阶段的发展目标。这个两个战略定位是支持前海打造粤港澳全面深化粤港澳大湾区全面深化改革的创新实验平台，建设高水平的对外门户枢纽。三大任务要求是支持香港经济社会发展，提升粤港澳合作水平，构建对外。 开放新格局，两阶段的发展目标是到2025年建立健全更高层次的开放型经济体制，初步形成具有全球竞争力的营商环境，对粤港澳大湾区的发展的引擎作用日益彰显。 到2035年，高水平对外开放体制机制更加完善，营商环境达到世界一流水平，建成全球资源配置能力强、创新策略能力强、协同发展带动能力强的高质量的发展引擎。前海合作区的面积也由14.92平方公里扩大到了120.56平方公里，现代服务业体系不断优化，将为前海改革开放提供更大的发展空间，为深港合作创造更多的机遇，也必将为广大企业带来更好的发展红利。一是营商环境优，我们实施优化营商环境3年行动计划，启动前海港澳一站通项目建设，为企业提供专心、真心、诚心、耐心、细心的五星服务，力争让企业收获暖心、舒心、放心、安心、称心、满意的五星满意。二是支持政策支持会，创新实施比特区还要特的先行先试政策。一是实施双十五的税收优惠政策，在现代物流、信息服务、科技服务、文化创意和商业服务等五大产业领域实施15%的企业所得税优惠，对境外高端紧缺人才实施15%的个人所得税优惠政策。二是实施外资奖励政策，对实际使用外资500万美元以上和增资300万美元以上的企业，奖励实际使用外资金额的1%，最高可达5000万元人民币。三是实施金融业发展支持政策，鼓励挂牌机构集聚，支持特色金融创新发展，金融租赁、商业保理企业经营奖励可达1000万元，支持深港金融合作创新发展，港资机构的奖励金额比照内资上浮20%。另外还实施办公用房的补贴政策，总部企业最高可获3000万元的办公用房补贴。三是创新动力强，累计推出制度创新成果685项，其中在全国复制推广65项，率先推出深港澳注册易、自然人企业开办秒批等创新举措，发挥好深港创新圈的优势。四是产业集聚金，汇丰、港交所、瑞银、嘉里、沃尔玛、IBM、利丰、思谋、普华永道、波士顿咨询等一大批知名的金融、现代物流、信息服务、科技和其他专业服务的企业在前海集聚，成为现代服务业高质量发展的新高地。五是人才汇聚高，依托人才领域3区1基地的平台优势，高水平打造了前海国际人才港，打造全球科技创新人才到粤港澳大湾区就业、创业和生活的第一站和首选地。六是法治保障特，全力推进中国特色社会主义法治建设示范区的建设，高水平打造前海深港国际法务区，率先实现港资、港法、港仲裁。七是金融支持10，打造跨境人民币贷款为代表的6个跨境金融特色产品，高水平建设前海深港国际金融城，金融开放窗口功能不断增强。八是内外循环畅，充分发挥机场、港口、会展中心等优势，依托前海综合保税区，实现了空港加会展加保税服务高效流转，不断增强内外循环链的功能。九是发展平台广，前海合作区扩区以后，发展条件得天独厚，地理位置优越，海陆空铁齐备，山海资源丰富，将为广大企业提供更广阔的发展空间。十是城市建设新，前海按照追求卓越、全球领先、未来城市的标准，以宜居、枢纽、韧性、智慧为特质，聚焦提升城市功能品质和综合承载力，加快构建富有活力和竞争力的国际化城市新中心。前海向前， 未来以来，当前的前海充满机会，充满想象，充满生机。我们也期待可以成为深港两地企业家朋友们的最佳合作伙伴，希望大家一起携手，共享前海发展的新机遇，共创湾区的新辉煌。最后，祝各位身体健康，万事如意，谢谢大家。
谢谢，谢谢，感谢袁先生您的详细分享，谢谢。那在活动一开始的时候呢，我们提过香港和深圳一直合作无间，而香港投资推广署及深圳市商务局也会继续的透过海外办事处向世界各地不同的地方做投资推广，宣传香港及深圳的商机。香港投资推广署及深圳市商务局将会借着今天的活动正式签署合作备忘录，推进两地联手做投资推广的合作。So as we mentioned earlier in the event, Hong Kong and Shenzhen have been collaborating closely on various aspects, while Invest Hong Kong and the Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality will continue to jointly promote the competitive advantages and business opportunities in Hong Kong and Shenzhen through the overseas economic and trade offices. And today, Invest Hong Kong and the Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality are going to sign a memorandum of understanding to take forward the collaboration on investment promotion. 以下的时间我们进入今天的签署备忘录的仪式。First of all, I would like to invite representatives on Hong Kong side to proceed on stage. Witnessing the signing on stage, we have Mr. Stephen Phillips, Director General of Investment Promotion of Invest Hong Kong. 掌声欢迎，首先我们邀请香港的代表，香港的见证人，首先有香港投资推广署署长傅仲森先生，掌声欢迎。We also have Mr. Guo Jingyou, Second Level Inspector of the Commercial Office of Economic Affairs Department of the Liaison Office of the Central People's Government in Hong Kong SAR. 中央人民政府驻香港特别行政区联络办公室经济部贸易处二级巡视员郭进友先生，掌声欢迎。现在我们有请签署人代表香港投资推广署助理署长业务发展蒋学礼博士来到台上就座。Now we would like to invite the signee representing Hong Kong, Dr. Jimmy Chang, Associate Director General of Investment Promotion, Business Development of Invest Hong Kong, to proceed on stage and be seated. Please welcome. Thank you very much. 接下来我们有请深圳的代表移步台上。Now we would like to invite representatives in Shenzhen to proceed on stage. 深圳的见证人代表有 witnessing the signing on stage we have.深圳市商务局局长张飞梦女士 Ms. 张飞梦 Director General of Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality Please welcome 掌声欢迎接下来我们有请深圳市前海深港现代服务业合作区管理局常务副局长黄晓鹏先生 Please welcome Mr. 黄晓鹏 First Deputy Director General of Authority of Qianhai Shenzhen Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Corporation Zone of Shenzhen to come on stage. Thank you. 现在我们有请深圳的签署人代表深圳市商务局副局长简正先生移步台上就座。Now we would like to invite the signee representing Shenzhen, Mr. Jiang Zheng, Deputy Director General of Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality to proceed on stage and be seated. 那我们签署仪式之前，我们先请签署双方的代表展示备忘录的文本，先来一张合影。Now we would like to invite the representatives of both parties to hold up the memorandum of understanding and first take a photo together. Please look at the camera at the center so that we're going to have a photo with our representatives from both the Hong Kong and Shenzhen side. 好，我们深圳的代表，请您把那个备忘录的文本再次拿起，我们不要挡住你的脸，我们要看到你俊朗的面孔，我们来一张合影，跟深圳和香港的代表，我们一起来一张合影。好的，谢谢。现在的时间，请两位的签署人准备好的话，就可以开始动笔签署，为深港两地进一步的合作，共创辉煌，写下新的一页。Now our representatives are going to sign on the memorandum of understanding, and this signifies the important collaboration.Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and congratulate both parties for this important moment. Thank you very much. 那现在这个重要的时刻，我们也要合照留念。现在我们请两位的签署人站立，移步到见证人的中间，并展示备忘录的文本，跟见证人一同在屏幕前拍照。 那我们双方两地的代表都已经准备好了，我们一起看一下台前我们中间的摄影师。那跟深圳的朋友讲一下，我们香港这边的屏幕呢，清楚看到你们三位的代表呢，也是在加入我们在香港的合照当中，非常非常美，也是合作无间的一个很好的象征。Thank you so much. And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. This concludes our signing ceremony. Thank you very much. Please return to your seats. Thank you. 那我们的签署仪式已经完成了，谢谢各位，可以先移步到台下就坐，谢谢。我们非常高兴能够见证双方签署合作备忘录，去落实今后的合作。那接下来呢，就是大家期待已久的专题交流环节。今天的主题是金融与现代服务业，我们非常荣幸邀请到几位重量级的嘉宾跟我们分享。 The next session is a long-awaited keynote forum on financial business and professional services industry. We're privileged to have invited distinguished guests to share with us today. And before we invite our guests to the stage, let me introduce them one by one.那我邀请我们香港现场的嘉宾来到台上之前，我先逐一的介绍。From Hong Kong, 我们在香港会场的嘉宾有来自 Alipay Financial Services Hong Kong Limited 行政总裁陈婉珍女士 ，Miss Jennifer Tan, Chief Executive Alipay Financial Services Hong Kong Limited. Please give a big round of applause to thank our speaker in advance.And we also have Ms. Jasmine Lee, partner, Chinese Inbound Business Leader, Financial Services, Ernst & Young Global Limited. 安永香港中资金融业务主管合伙人李顺儿女士，请欢迎。接着我们还有戴德梁行大中华区环球董事行政总裁赵景全先生 ,Mr. KK Chu, Chief Executive of Greater China, Cushman & Wakefield, please welcome.那我们在深圳会场的嘉宾有深圳市创新投资集团有限公司副总裁张建先生 Mr. Paul Zhang, Vice President Shenzhen Capital Group Company Limited will be joining in Shenzhen. And we also have Mr. Guo Yi, Partner and Managing Director Boston Consulting Group, also joining in Shenzhen to speak for us. 在深圳的另外一位嘉宾是波士顿咨询公司 BCG 全球合伙人兼董事总经理郭毅先生。那现在我们有请香港的几位嘉宾移步到台上就坐，有请几位掌声欢迎。Once again, please welcome our guests here in Hong Kong to proceed on stage and join for the forum. <音>那我们深圳的嘉宾们都已经准备好了，那我们事不宜迟，就进入我们今天论坛那个交流会的环节。那首先呢，第一道问题我想问一下来自戴德梁行的赵先生。那第一道问题呢，就想问一下。深圳、香港作为粤港澳大湾区的两个金融中心，哈，无论是金融市场或者是机构等等的规模，实在也是实力非常大的。那互补性很强的同时，那深港联手共建的金融中心各自拥有哪一些的优势呢？还有未来你看到有什么有机会需要解决的问题呢？
我相信刚才Steven 呢那个已经说了蛮多。有关于香港的那个和深圳的优势，我那个也把这一个说出来，那个抽一些出来说一下吧。因为看一下那个香港呢，那个本身来说是一个有比较好的那个金融平台。在那个我们香港来说，也有一个比较完善的那个法律的那个制度。在那个香港呢，也有一个是比较。我们说是那个非常大的一个IPO 的那个基本市场。其实我们在2020年是那个香港那个联交所呢为151家公司筹值的那个大概3981个那个港元。对于那个实际上是非常多的公司呢过来香港这边投资。这个是非常非常大的一个市场。实际上呢，在过去20年，香港筹资基金的那个是，有7年是那个全球第一，当然现在呢，那个竞争也蛮大。我们现在呢也有一个好处，就是那个能够把一些过去在美国上市的一些中国的公司，把它吸引过来香港， 这个也是我们现在那个金融市场上面的优势。
嗯，
还有呢，就是我们现在也是那个全球最大的人民币业务中心，在2021年，香港的那个代理的人民币贸易总额是超过7万亿人民币，这个也是一个非常大的金额，占了全球的市场的大概75%，这个是非常非常大的。我相信这个市场呢还会继续那个加大，这个是那个我们香港的优势。基于那个深圳呢有那个世界企业的那个科创中心，也是一个高端制造业的基地，这个呢也是一个非常非常好的一个那个趋势。还有呢，深圳也是一个在最近前几年呢，他们也把那个金融服务业那个也那个创造出来，跟香港呢是那个互相呼应，这个是非常非常好的一个趋势。还有呢，在过去深圳也是第一批发行这个数字人民币的一个中心，也这个呢也是一个非常创新的一个部分。深圳呢也是一个非常创新有先行先试的一个平台，所以呢在这一方面是那个香港和深圳在这一些方面呢，除了刚才 Steven 呢还说的更多，我呢那个只是那个抽了一部分出来说啊，因为时间的问题啊，
就拿了一些重点来看。不过我们刚刚听的都听得到，就是香港跟深圳的优点，其实他们就是互相的合作，可以看到很好的一种synergy， 就是互相可以互补啊，还有更好的一个提升的状态。那刚刚我的问题也有提到，就是说未来有没有什么样的问题你看到有机会我们未来需要解决的呢？
其实问题来说是应该是很多的，因为呢坦白说我们第一个看到，就是因为我是那个专门是做房地产的，第一时间呢就看到房地产方面的那个问题。香港现在的那个租金很高啊，那个譬如说我们说在那个中环那个 CBD 的那个租金呢超过160块钱的那个每一个平方尺，可是那个在深圳那个福田呢现在呢大概200多啊，这一个那个租金的差距，为什么说那个是问题，也可能是一个契机啊。对我们来说是那个说啊，租金这样贵，香港是否没有那个竞争力了？对我个人来说，这个是两方面去看，因为有一方面我们可以看的是，看到那个蛮多的那个银行或者是一些金融机构。他们现在呢有很多的后台的工作，也不需要一定要放在香港，可是因为香港是那个金融中心，我们很多时间呢可以把一些后台的那个地方那个服务呢放到深圳去，他们可以那个租用比较便宜一点的那个深圳地方啊，这个是一个部分。另外一个部分呢就是有一些比较接近大湾区的服务呢，我相信也可以那个放到那个深圳去的，这个是一点。另外一点呢，就是现在蛮多的那个那个中国的企业要跑出去，也有一些那个外国的企业那个跑进来，很多时间在合业方面、合同方面呢，很多时间呢也有一个不同的看法。在这一个情况之下，很多时间呢在合同里面呢。也会写一些是有关于做 arbitration 啊，或者是一些有诉讼的时间用哪一个国家的那个法规去做。其实我相信在过去那个几样多年呢，国际仲裁是那个非常普遍的，尤其是在商务方面。我觉得那个现在我们可以看能不能够在这一个部分，香港和那个深圳有一个共同的一个国际仲裁中心，这样的话那个我相信是那个可以把整个深圳和那个香港呢有很多的那个合同是用这一些方法去解决，是那个相比较用那个去跑到法庭里面用法庭的那个去处理这个问题呢更好。 可是呢，这一个呢，必须要有一个，刚才那个 Steven 也说了，那个有关于 professional services 方面的事情，因为呢，在这一个部分呢，我相信有很多要磨合啊，因为那个现在互认还不是那个完全100%成功，我们相信呢，在这一部分，无论政府也好，那个香港政府也好，深圳政府也好，也可能要协作那个专业在这一方面是否可以把一些无论是那个法律方面会计方面建筑方面的那个专业，他们在那个互认方面是否可以那个能够协调，或者是那个在这一部分呢能够推动一下，因为在我们来说看到的是那个现在有很多还是有一点不协调的那个地方，所以呢在这一方面呢可能呢将来我们也希望无论是那个，因为在我们这个那个行业来说呢我们上面呢就是那个Development Bureau 啊，那个可能呢在那个 Accountant 方面呢他们上面是那个那个财政司啊，所以呢在这一方面我觉得是那个很多很多呢也需要那个不同的局可能呢那个要帮手去那个协作解决一方面的问题。
嗯，刚才说 Development Bureau 就是发展局，
发展局啊，
就是政府的不同的部门可能要做不同的工作去推动一下。嗯，刚刚赵先生就说了，就除了一些比如说现在合同上的问题啊，除了现在很多的比如说调解的方法，可能是仲裁也是一个新的方法去调整。那我们看一下未来有什么新的政策可以，那我们业界也可以继续的讨论。谢谢。好，接下来呢我们第二道问题呢是想要问一下深圳创新投资集团的张先生的。那张先生，我们第二道问题呢想问一下您资本市场呢不仅仅是区域经济发展的重要组成部分，那同时呢也已经成为了推动大湾区建设的重要力量。我们想请您从投资行业的角度跟我们谈谈，就是未来如何通过资本市场来强化深港两地的创新合作，你的看法是什么样的呢？
好，谢谢主持人啊。那个，我想呢，在回答这问题之前啊，先讲几个背景啊。那么，其实现在呢，这个深港合作呢，应该是由来已久啊。从这个前店后厂到现在，这样的一个双城经济呢，其实这个已经取得了突破的进展。那么在2021年呢，这个深港的经济体量已经达到了8130亿美元，那么这个已经超过了这个全球这个第20名的这个经济体量瑞士。那么呢在2020年的一份报告中，也就是评选了深圳、香港、广州这样一个城市群呢是全球第二的这样一个创新这个集群。那么另外呢就是一个背景，我想就是说呢，其实创新呢是不断的推动创新成为支撑和这个作为这个经济体系和这种发展模式的一个新的一个这个引领和支撑。另外呢就是金融怎么样能够服务这个实体经济，这个是作为这个金融应该是未来最重要的一个出发点和落脚点。那么当然了，还有就是最近的这样的一个这个国际形势哈，那么就是整个的俄乌冲突啊，包括疫情的反复啊，包括这个欧美的这个通胀哈，那么确实可能给经济发展的这种带来了很多的一些不确定因素，像不管是香港还是深圳呢，可能都受到了一些影响。但是呢，在这样的一个情况下，那么其实5月份啊，这个青科的统计呢，这个全国的整个的投融资是面临了一个腰斩的一个，就是这个量和额啊，面临了一个腰斩的一个不利局面。虽然是这样吧，我想在这样的一个情况下呢，那么可能我们才更应该去保持这样一个定力，去增强一个信心。那么，所以我们今天呢，可能就讨论一下我们怎么样能够，金融怎么样能够更好的去这个服务这个科技创新领域。那我想呢，今天有几个观点吧，或者是建议啊。那么第一呢，就是还是要这个大力促进这种能够让这个就是我们叫 QFLP 吧，就是能够让这个有一个更好的这个投融资平台，投融资的便利性，那么能够设立这样的一个一级市场的 海外融资和投资的这样的一个中转港。那么因为其实由于现在的这种国际形势啊，那么确实国外美国啊或者是国外的一些这种机构的投资者呢要进入中国其实还是有一定的一个限制。那么通过借到香港或者港澳呢能够去通过 QFLP 来去投资或者说这个参与内地或者说湾区的这样的一个股权私募股权投资基金，能够进一步能够参与到这个大湾区的科技创新企业里面来，我想这个呢是为未来呢会是一个非常就是给市场提供了一个非常大的一个源头活水吧，所以呢应该说是非常重要对大湾区未来的一个健康发展，所以这个 QFLP 呢能够起到它一个核心的作用。另外呢就是这个内地的人民币的资金呢，如果说能够通过内地的募集呢，能够通过 QDIE 啊，那么当然也是香港也是咱们的这个第一个这个战场吧，或者说这个出去的一个中转，那么能够投资呢，包括像以色列啊，包括像欧洲啊一些创新的公司，能够给咱们也能够让我们的创投机构呢能够国际化，能够去这个投资这个国际最前沿的一些科学技术和这个能够去获得一些国际化的一些顶尖人才，这是第一。第二呢，就是我们怎么能够更好的让这个让我们这个退出风投创投的一个退出能够有这个更拓宽这样的一个渠道，因为当然了，还有包括我们的这个资本市场能够给予更多的一些耐心啊。那么确实创投风投呢这个随着这个国内应该说这个整个的一个资本市场的发展吧，那么创投机构呢能够有稳定的一个退出和上市的就是一个预期或者说退出的估值的一个预期呢，那么其实能够去很好的让他们就让这个更多的一些创新创业的团队呢能够得到这个创投机构的一个持续的一个稳定的一个发展。那么就拿比方像我们深创投来说，那么我们2023年我们投资了1200多家企业，那么已经有217家企业在全球的资本市场上市，那么确实呢这个应该说这个国内资本市场的一个稳定的一个发展呢给了我们很大的这样的一个这个发展的一个动力吧，那么也让我们能够持续的这个用资金来去投入到对这个新的科创企业的一个支持上来，这是第二点。那么第三点就是说是不是能有一些创新的一些比如说深港两地能够去合作，从这个基金的合作角度，从创投的角度哈，那么就是说大家的各个政府能够去从引导基金能够出资，然后呢我们在各自的这个两地呢能够去社会化的募集这个资本，然后呢去投资两地的一个这个合作的这个企业，那么当然呢能够利用这个河套的这个深港科技创新的合作区的一些好的一些这个政策或者说资源优势，那么同时呢能够利用两地的这些优势的创投机构的一些资源能够去给这个创新的企业做赋能，能够去支持这个粤港澳大湾区的一些青年的一些创新创业，我想这应该也说是这个后面是不是可以去做一个进一步的一个探讨和研究哈。那当然最后一个就是说那个能够去大力发展这个深港两地的一个科技金融的一个这个发展，这个能够去引入更多的这个国际的金融机构，能够使这个深港呢成为一个国际全球一流的这个国际金融机构金融人才包括金融这个产品的一个集聚地那么能够合力打造整个的一个这个金融的这个创新中心，金融的这样的一个科技中心和这个金融要素的这种这个交易中心，好吧，谢谢。
谢谢张先生。那刚刚提到其实资本市场也是很重要哈，对于整个我们如何深化两地的合作，还有一些比如说新的公司，还有刚刚张先生就从他创投的这个方向来看资本市场也有很好的一个工具啊，或者是不同的方法来帮助两地的一个合作，还有公司来我们的两地来发展也是非常好的。那我们下一道问题呢回到我们香港的现场。So the next question will come back to our guest in Hong Kong. And the next question we would like to direct this to Ms. Jennifer Tan from Alipay. Since your launch in 2017, Alipay Hong Kong has already accumulated over 3.3 million users and over 90% of local retail outlets support Alipay Hong Kong electronic wallet for payment, covering large chain stores, supermarkets, fresh markets, restaurants, and it certainly brings Hong Kong people to a new era of financial technology, and I enjoy using Alipay Hong Kong a lot as well. So do you have any advice or tips for the fintech companies who are interested in setting up in Hong Kong, and can you share your experience of developing in Hong Kong with us?
First, thank you for having me join this session. And actually, this is a pretty long question. So, but I would like to answer the part two first, okay? Because before I giving the tips, I think just back in 2017, actually at that time fintech, which is quite new to most of the Hong Kong people, and I still recall when I first took up this role as a CE and then to plan about how to launch a service. Actually, I got a lot of discouragement instead of encouragement. Reason is because everyone told me, Hong Kong people, almost on average, everyone got 5 credit cards. And you got Autobus, which has been dominating this market for so many years. So why, we still need another payment method? So that's a big doubt. Okay, but as I say, I'm so lucky because I convinced the investor to trust me, okay? And so we have this Alipay Hong Kong. But I think, because a lot of people, when they thirst, they think, Hong Kong already have a lot of payment methods. Why we still need a new electronic payment? Actually, to a lot of people's supply, I would tell them, that at that time, over 60% of our retail transactions was still conducted in cash. Although we understand, Autobus is very strong, but they are actually strong in micropayment. And, credit cards is very also, have a lot of market share, but they are actually strong in, large amount transactions. So actually there's a pretty, big, just hole is that, nobody served those, medium-sized transactions. And second thing is that, for lots of merchants, actually, a lot of them actually are SMEs. Unlike the large organization, they don't have resources, they don't have the IT knowledge. So for them, they don't know how to upgrade their servers. And digital transformation to them is just a buzzword. Everyone talk about digital transformation. They don't know how to do it. And QR code actually is a perfect solution for them because it's a simple, and it is also low cost or zero cost to them. So as an industry player, we think there's a very good position for us. And that's why we roll out service, and also we position it is not only a payment method, because it is not only just an app provide you a payment function. We actually offer you a lifestyle solution. So for example, you just consider, we have two types of customers. For the general wallet users, we are not only facilitating them for payment. Okay, we actually offer them, solution from offline retail purchase to online. They can even also solve their, personal issues, say for example, like paying, bills. They can pay their children's school fees. They can, make a digital donation. They can buy insurance. So it's just, we try to provide service, to address a lot of personal, personal issues. And from the merchant side, as I mentioned that, we also help them, just by using a QR code. If you are a SME, you just use a A4 paper to print out the QR code. You already can enjoy digital transformation. You can already, tell your, just tell your customers, say, very proud of them. We can accept electronic payment. So this is, how, we think about, and then we roll out to the market. And of course, you can see, after a few days, we actually achieved 3.3 million user and over 90% of the merchants accept this. And back to tips. I think for tips is, I recall, Stephen mentioned that Hong Kong is a very good testing place for a lot of technology. Actually, Hong Kong is small, but bear in mind, we have very, very high penetration of smartphones. Okay, I think on average, everyone got about 2-3 phones, okay? And also, one thing is that you can't believe, but actually, is that even for those elderly people in Hong Kong, they use smartphone very, I would say smart, you know, they are very, get used to that. And so in general, if you got any new technology, you want to try, you want to test, Hong Kong is a very good testing place. And, but of course, we're talking about a good testing space, but why somebody will be very successful, some maybe, you know, find it very challenging. The most important thing I think is first, customer value. When you offer a solution, and you have app, first you need to understand, what do, is this a customer value? A lot of people, I talk to them, they think that, you know, they have a creative idea, very nice, they want to launch it, but they never think about, is that what really your customer needs? That is very important. And second thing is localization. You cannot just, you know, okay, you can just say, oh, I just use, you know, say like Alipay. Alipay is a very popular app in China. So I just bring it to Hong Kong, done. If you compare our Alipay Hong Kong with Alipay China, you may think it is totally two different apps. Why we do that is because we consider the local people's preference, your user behavior. Say, for example, in China, they like to use the index finger. Why in Hong Kong? We use the thumb. So that's where, you know, we even the look, you know, in our UX, UI design, where we put those icons and how many icons, we all have very scientific, you know, analysis. And second thing is, you know, culture. You know, each place, you know, people have different culture. So it is very important, you need to really understand what is, you know, the favorite of the local people. Say, for example, we have eSTAMP. A lot of our users love it. Every time by, you know, have one or two transactions, they got $1 or $2. But, you know, this is actually a breakthrough. Not even in China. We are the one, because why we think about this one is because in Hong Kong, a lot of people like to collect those stamps, right? And this is why you need to collect the stamp, why we can't just convert into eStamp. And that is how we think about that. And this is also very well received by our user, and even a lot, I understand a lot of, you know, you know, other you know, players also follow that. So I think that is very important. You need to understand your user. You need to really provide a service which, you know, which they think it is part of their lifestyle. That is important.
Right, so customer value and culture,
yeah, culture
are the very important elements that you want, yes, to consider if, right, you want to come into this place and, mm-hmm, to know about what they really like. Mm. Yeah, I like collecting stamps too, so I really love that. All right, thank you, Jennifer, for sharing that much, and really impressive for the development over the past 5 years. The next question we have is about modern service industry. And I would like to ask our guest in Shenzhen. 那下一套问题呢是有关于现代服务业的，我们想问一下来，身处在深圳的波士顿咨询公司的郭先生。那想问一下这个问题呢，我们是这样想要知道的，是在共建粤港澳大湾区的背景下，现代的服务业中有哪一些潜在的创新方向？你是看到的，可以跟我们分享一下吗？
我觉得在这个大的呀，这个国际环境出现了很多变化的情况下，我们今天再来谈这个粤港澳大湾区现代服务业的建设是更有意义的，对吧？因为在过去国际化在一个高峰的时候，其实这种内外循环的结合相对会更容易做。换句话说，在很多地方都可以做得到，是吧？与国际的接轨。但自从疫情以来啊，特别是 国际化的这个趋势出现这种区域化这种合作更多的情况下呢，我们感觉像深港这样，像刚用 Twin City， 对吧？其实在美国有 Twin City， 那么深港两地如此近的两个体量相当的经济体的紧密协作就显得更加有意义。那么具体来说呢，我觉得主要的第一个机会，我看来啊，应该说是内外循环下 如何去寻找这种现代服务业的前店后厂的一种机会点。其实刚刚有嘉宾也提到过，就是说如何更好地利用中国大陆的这种广大的市场，但同时又能利用好香港在各种法律法规啊，即这种机制上的一种错配的这种优势，形成优势互补，对吧？ 那么以前店后厂的方式，比如在香港探索很多新的服务的模式，新的业务，而将这些新的模式、新的业务的机会呢， 在中国大陆中啊，在广泛的加以借鉴及应用啊，我觉得这个机会是我现在看来可以说是一个历史赋予的粤港澳大湾区整体的这个现代服务业的一个机会。那么在这个机会下呢，我个人感觉啊，如何往下走还有两个大的机会点啊，我们一直讲什么呢，一个叫数字的产业化，就是如何将数字化数字经济进行产业的场景的探索啊，将科技就是现在大家看到的 ARVR 啊或者其他的各方区块链呢、啊、各方面的技术把它带入到具体的产业的场景中来，使它形成产业化。那么在形成了数字产业化后带来的下一句话就叫产业的数字化，那么就如何将这些技术更好的打包融合啊 integrate 在一起，那么形成每个产业所能形成的啊这样子的数字化的网络，或者咱们俗称的产业互联网。我觉得其实整体的现代服务业未来的机会点可以说就出在这八个字，就是数字的产业化以及由它所推动的产业数字化中，那么现代服务业金融业咨询业对吧，我们的 auditing lawyer 如何配合这八个字形成自身业务的一个探索，我觉得这是一个未来的一个机会点。主持人
好，谢谢郭先生。那刚刚郭先生的重点呢就是说啊，我们可以看一下怎么样去利用两地的优势来一个前店后厂，然后呢还有两个就是我们怎么样去做数字产业化产业数字化，这些也是我们啊可以去探讨的一些地方。谢谢郭先生，谢谢。So the next question we have will be back here in Hong Kong, and would like to pose the question to Ms. Jasmine Lee from Ernst & Young. 那我们下一道问题呢是给我们香港的嘉宾的。So the question is, with the increase in connectivity between the financial market of Hong Kong and that of mainland China, such as Wealth Management Connect, Qualified Foreign Limited Partnership, and Bond Connect, how do you see its future development and opportunities for overseas companies in financial and professional services?
Thank you. So that's great. I can have a lot of time, right, to answer this question. So I think this question is, thank you for raising this question to me. I think this is a really good and very important question. So I did prepare a bit. So please bear with me and don't leave, right? I'm just kidding. Won't be too long. All right. And I also wrote some notes because I just want to make sure that the years I mentioned would not be wrongly quoted. So I just want to probably start off by describing this connectivity by refreshing all you guys' memory as to, you know, how this, the timeline of this connectivity is going. So I guess as Mr. Zhang has indicated, the QLFLP is actually very important, right? So back in 2010, in Shanghai, we started off with the QLFLP in the first pilot city in Shanghai. And throughout all these years until 2021, we see a lot of developments and changes and expansion. So a lot of cities are added into the pilot city to join this program. And then we actually see the development of the very important Stock Connect, you know, with in 2014, I guess, in Shanghai, and then 2016 in Shenzhen. So that's another major milestone. And then we proceeded to have the 2017 Bond Connect, which is the northbound,
right.
And that is a very major development in progress. And then not long ago, last year, September 2021, we started off with the southbound. So that's complete Bond Connect program.
Mm-hmm.
And a very, very important one, the Wealth Management Connect, September 2021 again. This is a very important milestone. And then last but not least, in May 2022, this year, ETF Connect.
Right.
So we have more products, in the stock exchange.
Mm-hmm.
And then also last but not least, the Insurance Connect, which is sort of like split into two phases. We start off the first phase, 2020, and then we'll be expecting the 2022.Maybe 2022 this year, the second phase, and I'm going to elaborate a little bit more on this. So when you look at all these, different connectivities, I think you have seen that it's actually it has not been ending. I mean, it has been continuously evolving in all these years. And if we look at it in a multidimensional perspective, we look at it in different perspectives. I guess we see, the disconnected, all these connectivities have actually escalated to a level high enough, right? The height of it, which clearly shows the importance of all this connectivity, whether it be in GBA or between Hong Kong with the, you know, with the entire China. That is a very important message. And then we also see in another dimension the breadth, I mean the width, right? That we see is actually expanding to a lot of products, right? And you get different products into it, you know, with insurance and bonds, and you know, so I guess a lot of players can actually enter into the market, you know, to be involved. And we also see the what we call the depth, right? So when you see actually the customer niche that can be exposed to, right, is was actually expanding from like, you know, corporations, limited, you know, groups of corporations wanting to join QFLP to a bigger group, corporations, and then we have even like a niche group of private wealth, like, you know, higher net worth individuals to retail who can join the WEM Connect. So I guess all these are really achievements, right? So I guess your first part of the question is, you know, what I see, right, with the development. So I guess there is development, but for sure it's very promising. I guess, you know, first of all, we would continue to see continuous development, definitely, right? Expansion, you know, with probably the size of the fund flow or the volume of transactions that you can actually have, right, on a daily basis, and also probably the amount of investments that each individual can make. I guess that's definitely will be expanding, and also the variety of products that you'll be seeing. So this is the first one. And then the second one, I just want to highlight a little bit on the Insurance Connect. I do see, I'm very bullish on that because I do see there's a huge demand, you know, from the China side on the types of insurance products that that they want to have. And also, it's a very large sector, right? With the aging population and the elderly and, you know, like all these different areas. So I guess the health sector, you know, overall, with the Insurance Connect, I guess that is a very important development that we should all be excited with. And the third thing is, I do see there is some increasing momentum of, you know, interest and enthusiasm from, you know, people on both sides, right, with all this connectivity. So I'm expecting, looking forward to that, you know, with people wanting to join more and invest more and be really understanding what can be offered in the GBA. And also, we hopefully we'll be able to see, well, actually, it's actually existing right now, the more collaboration between the regulator and also the industry practitioner. So I do see this all, you know, major development. So ideally speaking, we can see probably GBA development will be a very promising one with improved enhancement in the effectiveness or efficiency of connecting, you know, between cities, and understanding more on the customer expectation, you know, what customers like. Like just like what Jennifer said, it's different between China and Hong Kong and Macau. And also we can see more, hopefully, innovative products that are coming up. So this is all the development viewpoint. Now, when you ask me about the opportunities, I guess, firstly, I'm going to shout out loudly to all the companies worldwide, you know, for Invest Hong Kong, that please come explore GBA, understand what's going on, you know. Although we have COVID, nothing has stopped. So probably, you know, continue to understand. And really, especially for the financial companies, financial service companies, we are opening up China, you know, for a lot of different sectors like banks and the private wealth sector and also insurance. So I guess, you know, that is the first opportunity. And second of all is, personally, in my day in and day out work, I also see a lot of opportunities in collaboration. We do need assistance with our industry practitioners. So I do see overseas companies who have expertise in technology, fintech, ESG, and also with the health sector, I guess, you know, we need a lot of, you know, expertise and you know, people that can help us. So collaboration opportunity. And more importantly, specifically for financial companies, I think depending on which sector that you're actually in, banking or wealth management or insurance, I do think there's a huge, you know, opportunity room you can actually develop to have your products there. But my personal viewpoint is the insurance sector and also the private wealth management. I guess that's the two most important sectors that we should be looking at and the financial service institutions can look at. And last but not least, don't forget we have the strongest, you know, capital market ability in Hong Kong. So our exchange, our fundraising ability, so whether be it like, you know, want to have ISO, IPO, bond issuance, or private placement, you know, this is the best place that you should come. And backed up by the, you know, the GBA, I think that's perfect. So all these are for the overseas companies to look at. Okay, and last but not least, professional service company. So like as Mr. Xu has said, well, let me do a little bit commercial here. I'm from UI, but I'm also, you know, talking more with, you know, for the entire accounting, auditing, consultancy. So I guess a tremendous opportunity for us, you know, as they go along, you know, striving for their success in the GBA journey, we are with them. So for example, like, you know, UI, we are a multidimensional, multidisciplinary service firm, so we can offer a lot of different services for companies that want to, you know, work in on GBA. So whether be it like, you know, doing the reporting in the IPO exercise, attestation work on ESG projects right now, consultancy for fintech, and also tax project, well, within GBA, did a lot of assistance in that. And also a lot of companies are also, you know, coming to for advice on strategy, you know, how they can actually capture the you know, the demographic preference, and, you know, how they're going to, you know, a lot of MNC companies actually doing that already with us. So I guess that's a huge, tremendous opportunity for us. We are in a very good timing. We are fortunate, and we're in a good position to work on that. And in fact, I just want to say, you know, EY is also opening up our innovation center also in Qianhai district. So, you know, in the third quarter of the year. So I'm very much looking forward to that. That's it.
All right, thank you so much, Jasmine, for the very comprehensive sharing. 那刚才女士呢就真的从高度、广度还有深度来讲了一下我们现在互联互通其实已经有很多很好的措施在帮忙。那未来的机遇方面，她觉得外面的公司一定要快一点的多一点了解我们大湾区的优势哈。然后呢，其实我们很多不同的相关的产业或者是不同的industry 就是不同的工业都可以来我们这边去有不同的合作，特别是专业服务方面也是很好很多的合作的机会的。好，今天非常感谢我们在深圳还有香港的各位嘉宾跟我们分享了那么多精辟的见解。Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a big round of applause to thank our guests here today and also in Shenzhen. Thank you very much for sharing with us. Thank you. Please return to your seat. Thank you very much. Okay, we'll pass our photo together. 我们深圳的嘉宾需要加入在这个合照的环节吗？要不我们深圳的嘉宾们可以的话，可以站立一下。我们呢，香港的会场呢，现在可以在屏幕上看到你们。那我们来一张合影，请我们的大会摄影师。同时也是，深圳的同事们可以把那个镜头往后挪一点点吗？那所以我们可以看到我们两位的嘉宾，谢谢，非常好。那我们五位的嘉宾。 要不我们一起看一下我们中间的大会摄影师，我们香港这边呢可以全部五位放到我们的镜头里面的，非常好，也是非常感谢各位今天的分享。那相信呢，无论是线上参与或者是现场出席的各位来宾朋友，都对香港和深圳两地的机会有了更深入的认识。好，谢谢我们深圳的嘉宾们，可以先到台下就坐，谢谢。 Thank you very much and please be seated. Thank you. So participants, I'm sure you have learned a lot more about Hong Kong and Shenzhen. If you would like to know more details, please contact one of our organizers, Invest Hong Kong, Commerce Bureau of Shenzhen Municipality, the authority of Qianhai Shenzhen, Hong Kong Modern Service Industry Cooperation Zone of Shenzhen for more information. 那今天的交流会呢，如果大家有任何的问题，也可以联络香港投资推广署、深圳市商务局或者是深圳市前海管理局。 Last but not least, we would like to remind all of you to take a moment to fill out the feedback form. It would be very helpful for us to know your views as well. And for other upcoming events, please stay tuned and do check out our websites. 那我们未来的活动呢还有很多，那邀请大家可以呢积极的留意我们几个单位的网页，还有我们的宣传平台。同一时间也提醒大家用几分钟的时间回答我们活动的反馈，让我们知道你们的意见。非常感激各位的来宾。 那再一次呢，感谢各位的莅临，也欢迎各位关注和参与香港投资推广署、深圳市商务局和深圳市前海管理局的其他活动。我们希望很快在其他的活动再跟大家见面。Once again, thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you in our next event. Thank you very much and goodbye.